Hey, it's your old pal Lucid Stew again. I'm going to go over one of my recent Twitch streams and talk about how to paint and make a tree. So I've grabbed my tree called Strong Medium Tree and I've taken it apart. And then I've duplicated the canopy portion. And the reason I've done that in this particular video is that I am experimenting and trying to use two different fleck types for the leaves. The way that I made these canopies was I used a half sphere and then I just cut away a bunch of pieces using the kaleidoscope tool, and that gave me a bunch of little clumps, and that makes it look a little bit more like bunches of leaves instead of a big hunk of stuff. And you can see that right there when I'm adjusting the impasto. So what I do with these is first I come in and I paint them real loosely with yellow, orange, and red with a low opacity and soft blend just to give it an overall non-green color. I use low opacity because you still want it to retain a little bit of green, because while leaves are turning, a lot of them still have green in them. So I'm going through here and I'm doing about the same thing with the second one, but I'm using a little harder color just to give those splashes of red and orange and have the foliage pop. So I'm combining the two and I'm just going around real quick and making sure everything's even. One thing about using a half sphere for this type of work is you end up with a really flat bottom, so you have to go through and kind of chip away at that. And it's a little bit more difficult than it actually sounds to get it a little bit more realistic looking. And another consequence of using that technique is you get a lot of little pieces hanging off on the edges, so you kind of have to go through it and cull out parts just to get a little bit looser shape and to clean up fleck parts that have kind of separated themselves from the main body of the thing, so you don't end up with leaves that are just hanging in empty space. So, and also I tried to clean out the middle a little bit so that the sun would shine through to the trunk. And then once I'm done with all that, I'm going through and just trying to fill in some of the larger gaps. And for that, I'm sculpting with a blend up fairly high, so I'm letting the engine do a little bit of work. And then at the end here, I'm just trying to add punches of color. So you get the greenness of the tree, but you also get that brilliant look that leaves have when they start to turn. Going overall for an autumn type of look with that, and then going around real quick and brightening up everything with a bright yellow to make it look like the sun's popping off of it. Okay, so the two fleck types I'm using here are circle and splat, and the reason I'm using those two is that when you're making leaves, circle lets you use relatively low looseness and it will create a smaller looking leaf. And then splat, in my opinion, is the fleck that by itself most looks like a leaf. So when you combine those two, you should get kind of a leaf texture with a smaller leaf texture, and the two combined ideally would look appealing. At the end there, I just pull out a sun and sky gadget so that I can make it presentable for its cover picture, and then finish up by grouping everything together. I'm going to be streaming a total probably of 5 or 6 times before the end of the beta, so there are going to be more videos like this. And then after the beta is done, I'm going to go through everything that I've streamed and I'm going to try to present it in a little bit more structured, scripted way that serves as a platform that's a little bit more instructional. So I will be making another video soon and I will see you next time.